you know, every once in a while, you've got to get yourself a new toy. So I've just got the latest Sony Handycam. I rang Sony this morning, and they didn't have this camera in stock. So I went to Michael's in Melbourne and spoke to a guy there, and he sorted me out probably, well, far better deal than Sony could ever have done. So just unpack my leads. So aside from the camera, he did me a deal on another battery, two 16 gig memory sticks. He did me a deal on another bigger battery. So this comes with this battery, which lasts about an hour and a half, but that's not really going to be that long out at the airport, I think. So this is a camera I'm going to be using. It's HDRAX2000, and Andre at Michael's in Melbourne sorted me out. He's given me a lens cover already, which he's put on. Wide angle, HD, it's got tons of stuff. Just look it up on the internet. As well as the camera, I've got a new, sturdier Velbon tripod. And I made sure there was no play in the head before I bought that one. And I had to buy a case for the camera, because yeah, a bag ain't going to cut it. And I also got a directional microphone and just a couple of leads and 16 gig cards, which he did me. That's a lead for the camera. So I'll set it up and you can have another look. You see the size the memory card comes in? These are 16 gig. I've got two of them. One. And here's the second one. And Andre said it just carries on recording onto the next card if the first one gets full. So that's the battery, the initial battery that's gone in, but he's ordered me a bigger one. If I want one that sticks out up, you know, out here, then I've got to pay around $500 for it. So it's currently charging. He's recommended 8 hours for the initial charge, and then eyepiece gone on. And then here's the microphone, directional microphone. With wind protector. And then I've just got to lock that in and plug the lead on, and the lead plugs in. It's got two recording outputs here, inputs. So that's a directional microphone setup, and here's the display. So this is just, I've just turned it on for the first time. Create a database, yes. So it's touch screen, which is pretty handy. It's doing it twice because there's two cards in there, and then it's coming up for the time to set Singapore. It's just staring out my window at the moment, so I'm just going to set that up. So I've just input the date and time, and it's saying it's on standby. There's 90 minutes in each memory card, 1080. And left and right microphone levels down the bottom. Hello! I'm ready to go, really. Oh, it's got a shutter. Let me open the shutter. It's a manual shutter. look at the lens on that. This is what I like about Apple and iMovie. I've just plugged my camera in. If I select automatic, it's found the USB. I told the camera, you know, use memory card A or just execute, and it's found the camera. And I'll just import. There's only one film. So this is my first recording. I'm going to put it on the same video, but essentially this was the Handycam that I was using. It's got a call Mikey tag in case I ever lost it, which means it can be returned to me with a unique number. Anyway, that's another story. So this was a Handycam, microphones on top, really small. It's one of the smallest Sony have done. And this is the second time I bought a small camera, and now I've gone for the professional one. And it's touchscreen display. And this is what I've been doing all my videos on. They were retailing for about $1,400 Australian, and I think they're similar price today. The new one does GPS. So it's well worth the money, and you can sneak them on a plane. Or you can get it out once the crew have gone. I think I'm going to have trouble with the big camera, so we'll see.